Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Wassalatu Wassalamu ala Sayyid al-Mursaleen. Amma ba'd, fa'a'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. My dear sweet Islamic brothers, let's recite durood and salam upon the beloved and blessed Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. As-salatu was-salamu alayki ya Rasulullah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya Habiballah. As-salatu was-salamu alayki ya Nabiyallah wa ala alika wa ashabika ya Nurallah. Excellence of durood and salam, the exalted Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, recite durood sharif upon me in your gatherings, as your reciting the durood sharif will be nur for you on the day of resurrection. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today's topic, people deprived of nur. The unfortunate people who do not offer salah, shave their beards, or keep it less than a fist length, disobey and distress their parents, prevent their children from following the Sharia so that they become modern and trendy, do not prevent their wife and adult daughters from immodesty, do not refrain from films and dramas and songs and musical instruments, unlawful occupations, interest-based businesses, adulteration and deception, and betrayal and dirty language, backbiting, tale-telling, fault-finding, immorality and misbehavior, offending or harming Muslims without a lawful reason, or do not refrain from the company of indecent and rude people, who miss salah and adopt fashion, or the people who look at attractive young boys with lust. There is a matter of concern for all of such people, if Allah Azza wa Jal and His beloved Rasool sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam become displeased, Iman is ruined because of sins. Surely they will have to face everlasting, unbearable punishment, and they will not get any nur on the bridge of Sirat. Sayyidina Imam Jalaluddin Sayyuti al-Shafi'i rahimahullahu ta'ala alayhi writes in his book Al-Badr al-Safira, indeed, your names, private conversations, sitting, fellowships, i.e. the people who you associate yourself with, are all recorded by Allah Azza wa Jal. On the Day of Judgment, it'll be announced, O son of so-and-so, this is your nur, and O the son of so-and-so, there is no nur for you. On the Day of Judgment, the hypocrites will become or coming in such a state that they will not possess the nur of Iman. The hypocrites will be extremely sorrow and regret when they see the nur of the fortunate believers. And they will beg them for some nur, but will not be given any nur, as Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Holy Quran, Para 27, Surah Hadid, verse 13, in the translation of Kanzul Iman, the day when hypocrites men and hypocrites women will say to the Muslims, look mercifully towards us so that we may gain some of your light. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of social media, bear in mind salvation and forgiveness is dependent upon death with Iman. It is stated in the blessed Hadith, deeds are dependent upon end, meaning death. Nobody has any guarantee that he will die with Iman. We are unaware what Allah Azza wa Jal has planned for us. And this is in fact a matter of great fear and concern. Even great pious people, rahamallahu ta'ala alayhi, feared a bad death. To gain more information in this regard, please listen to the bayan entitled Allah Azza wa Jal ki khufiya tadbeer, inshallah azza wa jal, you will get the fear of Allah azza wa jal by listening to this bayan. Further, obtain a small Madani booklet entitled Causes for a Bad End. If you read this booklet attentively and seriously, you will cry for the protection of your iman. Nowadays, people blunt blasphemous words during everyday normal conversation, and we don't even realize. It is fard on every mature male and female to acquire the religious knowledge regarding blasphemous words. Obtain the booklet entitled Iman Ki Ifazat, which contains approximately 500 examples of blasphemous words. Also obtain a pocket-sized booklet entitled 28 words of profanity, meaning kufr. This booklet contains example of profound words that are usually spoken at home. My Madani advice is that you buy these low-priced booklets in the quantity of 1,200. Or if you can't buy 1,200, then buy 112 or at least 12 and distribute them. If convenient, kindly persuade your local news agents or any other bookshops, newspaper agencies, and ask them to distribute these booklets while sending the newspaper. In this way, you are given booklets will be delivered to other Muslims, and you will also, well, as the one delivering the booklets, will be entitled to a great reward. The Sunnah Inspiring Bayan and the Madani booklets can be purchased from Maktabatul Madina, which we have here in Fazan Madina. Or if you can't come to Fazan Madina, you could go on www.dawateislami.net on the website and go to the book and library section, and you can obtain these booklets free of charge. So may Allah Azza wa Jal give us the ability to act upon what is being heard and to pass on what is being heard. And inshallah, may Allah Azza wa Jal enlighten our hearts and give us the vision of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidil mursaleen. Jazallahu anna muhammadan ma huwa ahlu. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, accept our salat al-asr. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, we have listened to a short dars. Give us the ability to act upon this dars and to also guide our youngsters toward goodness. Ya Allah Azawajal, bless our iman, protect our iman, and give us death with iman in the beautiful city of Madinatul Manawwara. Bless our children with true iman. Give them the love of the Quran, the love of the Sunnah, the love for their parents. Ya Allah Azawajal, and give them the ability to travel to Makkah and Medina. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, bless our parents at home, our brothers and sisters, give them true iman. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, those who are affected by the pandemic, give them relief and give them shifa for the sake of Karbala. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, we don't know when we will die. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, give us the ability to do good deeds, and Ya Allah, to prepare for the akhirah by doing preparations. Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, before we die, in the state of, Ya Allah, the month of Ramadan is approaching us as well. Give us ability to fast in the month of Ramadan and to fulfill our qadha. If you have missed any of our salahs, to fulfill our salahs. Ya Allah, Azawajal, accept the du'as of the majlis. Give them true iman and accept the du'as. Sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. والحمد لله رب العالمين.